David Morris recently won the title of International Grandmaster World Champion at the International Whistling Convention held annually in North Carolina. His new CD, David Morris Presents World Champion Whistling, is available at our promotional table tonight. It includes several of the tunes featured on tonight's program. And David and his lovely wife, Helen, will be at the promotional table during intermission, and he will autograph those for you. He has chosen for his first number, Trumpet Voluntary by John Stanley. He lived from 1713 until 1786. He was an English composer and noted organist, and though blind from the age of two, he became master of the king's music in 1779. This voluntary, while not as well known as Jeremiah Clark's, lends itself beautifully to whistling. Ladies and gentlemen, from cold and rainy England, the dashing and debonair, Mr. David Morris.
Thank you. Thank you.
David, it is wonderful to have you back with us here in St. Louis.
It's lovely to be back in very hot St. Louis.
A little warm.
It's just about 40 degrees warmer than what I'm used to.
And you are certainly in fine whistle tonight.
Oh, thank you.
David will now whistle a beautiful tune from Les Mis. It's called Bring Him Home.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
That is beautiful.
Thank you.
That's on your second CD, right?
It is, yes.
It's beautiful. This next song is from his first CD, and this is my favorite one on that CD. It's called Zardes. It's a Hungarian-style folk dance with rapidly changing tempo, which entrances the listener and then delights with its gaiety. A good degree of control is required to bring this piece to its full glory, and David does it very, very well. Zardes.
Thank you. Thank you, Edward. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. See you later.
Mr. David Morris. That encore was, of course, The Flight of the Bumblebee by Rimsky-Korsakov. That was from his opera, The Legend of Tsar Saltan, in which a prince becomes a bee and stings his villainous relatives. Ow! I'm going to tell you about a few things to do at intermission now, because there's plenty to do. You could join the bandwagon. There are two raffles going on. One is for our band quilt made by Arlene, and you just need to go over and see that at our promotional table. Also, David Morris will be autographing his CD. We also have a new book for sale over at the promotional table tonight. It's called Still Shining. It's Discovering Lost Treasures from the 1904 World's Fair by Diane Rademacher, and she is here tonight autographing that book. The book describes the fair that was and still is, buildings, statues, and exhibit items located in St. Louis and around the country are pictured and featured in this book. The book is $20, and $5 from every book goes to help the band. She will be here next week also, so if you don't have your $20 tonight, you can bring it next week. This is The March of the Olympians by Walker. John Williams composed the music and served as music director for nearly 80 films, including Saving Private Ryan, Amistad, 7 Years in Tibet, The Lost World, Sleepers, Sabrina, Schindler's List, Jurassic Park, Home Alone, Far and Away, JFK, Hook, Indiana Jones Trilogy, The Accidental Tourist, Empire of the Sun, E.T., The Empire Strikes Back, Superman, Close Encounters of the Third Kind, Jaws, and Goodbye, Mr. Chips. That's just a small sampling of his 80 films. This is the theme from Superman by John Williams. Thank you. That was Call of the Champions by John Williams, the official theme of the 2002 Olympic Winter Games. This next piece, Hymn to New England, is from John Williams' recording called American Journey. It premiered Williams' official theme for the 2002 Winter Olympics in Salt Lake City, and it included recordings of six other works by Williams, most in their recording premieres. The six movement title work, Jubilee, Song for World Peace, the mission theme, which now is the theme for NBC News, For New York, variations on themes of Leonard Bernstein, Sound the Bells, Hymn to New England, and Celebrate Discovery. From American Journey, Hymn to New England by John Williams.